What was the decision that prompted you to write the book?
I dropped out of school when I was 15. My high school principal told me I'd amount to nothing. He could have been right, I don't know. But I think we all have a book within us. We all have a story within us. But for me, it was this compelling thing going on within me that I wanted to... People have always come to me for advice, and that's just grown and grown and grown into the point where I mentor people spiritually. I spent a lot of time talking with people about spirituality. They kept asking me for more and more and more, and I'd always wanted to put my thoughts and ideas into a book, and that's where Thirsty came from. I originally wrote it to my daughters as a book that they could use on their journey to help them. That was my whole intention behind the book. That was who I was talking to, my two daughters. And my publicist said, look, you know, I think what's in this book is meant for more than just that narrow demographic. I think there's more, you can offer this to so many more people, help so many more people. So that's how it kind of evolved.
Was it difficult for you to write? No, it just happened.
It was just like, that's how the book came out.
Yeah. So what sort of time frame did it take you? Because I know people
30 years.
Yeah, well, that's right. 30 years of experience, isn't it?
Yeah. Look, I wrote the book in probably 3 months.
Yes, that's quick to turn out.
Yeah, but it was there. It was within me. So there was nothing there that was, it just came out.
So are the books in the pipeline, I imagine?
Oh, look, I've got to slow down. I mean, this year I've released 2 books this year, and I need to slow down. I need to focus on this work. This is really important. This is more important as writing books for the sake of writing books. I think I could write a book every year, no problem. There's so much that I feel within me, but what I want to do, I want to harness what we've done, and I want to take that to the people, and I want it to matter. I want people's lives to be impacted and changed by them grabbing what's in my book, applying it to their lives, looking within, and moving forward in their own sovereignty.
It's just amazing to be able to be intuitive enough and feel that that's what needs to be done, because it's a big thing to basically put things aside. This is what I'm going to do. This is my passion. And what resonates about you is your authenticity. And
thank you.
That was one of the things that in your marketing book that I picked up was selling your authentic story. And that's something that I feel that you're doing for other people, but you're asking them to do it for themselves as well.
So, look, you know, you can't fake sincerity, and you can't buy integrity. So you have to be your authentic self, and that's the pathway to spirituality. Again, you know, it was Jesus who said, "The truth will set you free." Gandhi said, "Be the change you want to see in the world." So you know, be your authentic self.
What's tonight all about?
Well, what we're doing is we're trying to take the idea of spirituality to the mainstream. So we're trying to bring down the whole message of what spirituality is. Like, there's a real awareness around the universe, there's a real awareness around universal thought. A lot of people are disgruntled with mainstream religion, and so what we have here is a real alternative to get people think about their own spirituality and to start looking within rather than looking outside of themselves to find answers.
So where else are you taking?
We're currently working on a roadshow. We've already been doing a lot of events at spiritual conferences, but what we want to do is transition our message out of that spiritual environment and take it mainstream. So we want to take it to the people. You know, every day in Australia, 127 people try and take their own lives. And every day in Australia, 8 people succeed at that. So there's a need, something's not working in our society. Moving forward from that, we'll be taking elements of tonight and putting that, building that into our roadshow. We want to make it main. We really want to appeal to the average person in the street. We want to make spirituality something that people aren't afraid of, but you know, those people that look into the stars at night and wonder, you know, is there more? Well, we want to say, well, you know what, there is, but looking into the stars is wonderful, but let's look within and see what's there, because religions have taught us that we need an external saviour, but to look within, you know, the truth is written on the tablet of your heart. It's there in within you, but we've been told for centuries not to look there.
So how do you get over the people that have the fear of sitting quietly and looking within?
I think how I present spirituality is that, you know what, everything is energy. So energy is spirituality. Spirituality is just a word. It's just a word we use. So I think people have a poor concept of what spirituality is. They think religion, they think crystals, they think New Age, they think a whole pile of things. And it's no wonder people are scared of it. It's no wonder people are afraid of it. Spirituality is just having an awareness of who you are in the grand scheme of things. And I guess if you were to ask me how many, well, somebody did actually ask me how many religions there were on the earth once, and I said, well, there's 7.5 billion people on the earth, so I would think that somewhere around that number, there'd probably be about 7.5 billion religions on the earth, because we all come to our own conclusions. That's why we have so many different versions of Christianity that can't get on, because they've all taken their own stance on it, rather than looking within and finding the truth that already rests within us.
Do you think that people make themselves purposely busy so they don't have to sit themselves?
I think it's the society we're in. I think there's a real, everything's a distraction. You know, you've got, you get up of a morning, you sort out the kids, you go to work, you go to a job that you probably don't like, then you you drive home from that job to get the kids ready to do dinner, then you might sit down and waste 2 hours watching television, then you go to bed, and then the whole thing starts again. So we live in this world of distraction, and we've actually fooled ourselves into believing that that's normal.
And it's such a big job to be able to change that culture and that thinking that's ingrained in us for generations. How do we do that?
I think you have to be intentional about, you have to have an awareness around the fact that you need to change, or something in your life needs to change. It was Albert Einstein who said, you can't solve a problem with the same level of thinking that created it. So if you keep doing what you've always done in your life, you're going to keep getting the same result. We need to look outside of what we know, and we need to maybe let go of some of the things that we've clung on to and believed as truth. Because a lot of our ideas around truth are wrong. So,
and it's a shame, because you mentioned before how many suicides are in Australia currently. We need to be able to capture people before they get to that crisis point in their life to be able to change what's wrong. So you've got 2 roadshows, and this is the beginning of your book launch. There's so many people that need your message.
Look, you know what, I don't really have a plan or an agenda. I just respond to what's happening. And I think for me, my passion is that, okay, I did 3 years of theological studies at university level. I was a pastor in a mainstream church. I've pretty much given my life to spirituality and my spiritual development. Like, I'm just about to go and spend a week in temples in Indonesia with Hindu masters, not because I want to become a Hindu, but because I want to learn more and understand more about this world we live in, and then take that and help people find themselves, find their own way. So my whole thought around that is that I'll do whatever I can to help people see that they're worthy of a good life, that they're deserving, and that there's hope.
And it's very difficult, because your stories are so different from the New Age trend that's around and has been around for the last 10 or 20 years. How can you see yourself different from that?
I think, unfortunately, humans love to put labels on things, and we love to put things in boxes, and we love to put names on things, and it just makes us feel safe about what we're doing. I don't brand or label what I'm doing. I think the best way for me to explain it is I just tell people how I see it, and I give them my view. I don't ask them to believe anything, because I'm not sure I believe anything. I just respond to the information that comes to me. So, yeah, it's... there's no agenda here. All I want people to do is look within, maybe lay down some of their belief systems, question some of their belief systems, because you know, from the time we arrive on the earth, we're told how to think, what to think, what to believe in, and most of us never actually get to look at that ourselves and explore, well, hang on, who am I really?
That's right, because as children, we agree with our parents' belief, and we grow up with that, and trying to educate people out of that normal way of thinking to be able to think for themselves can be quite difficult. So it's a real shift of culture, isn't it? So,
yeah, and people, one of the questions I get asked is, how do I become more spiritual? And I respond to that by saying, well, you can't become more of what you already are. It's like me asking you, how do I become more human? I'm as human as I'm going to get. I'm not going to ever become more human than what I am today. But what it is, it's our awareness and our understanding around what we call spirituality. That's what's important, that we invest our time, our resources, our intention into our awareness of who we are and how we fit into this universe.
So the feeling that, you know, a lot of people say to me, you know, how do I become more intuitive? And I'm sure that you get asked the question, like you mentioned before, how do I become more spiritual? How do I connect with my true purpose? Because a lot of people believe that their purpose is doing something for other people in a spiritual way. How do you explain it to them that it's really being connected with themselves?
It's a hard thing to explain to somebody who, I mean, everybody has an awareness that there's something more than just themselves, and they belong to something more than just themselves. And most people have a belief or an idea around the fact that, well, we're more than just this. So I think that's the best place to start. I mean, none of this needs to be complicated, and I think in simplicity there's beauty. You know, never underestimate the beauty of simplicity. It's kind of like, it was actually Jesus who said, you've got to become like a child. You know, you've just got to lay down the layers, you've got to strip away the layers until you just get to that point where you remember who you are.
Yeah, and a lot of people are frightened to find out who they are because, well, what if I change and I don't like who I am, don't like me, they see me differently. It's that fear thing that often holds people back, isn't it?
Mm.
So it's trying to get past that.
Mm.
So,
yeah.
Again, it's a difficult thing to do, isn't it? Giving them the confidence, I suppose, to be able to be themselves and look within and give that monkey in their mind a banana.
Yeah. Well, you know, we're told we're not worthy, we're told that we're filthy, rotten sinners, you know, the government doesn't trust us, religion doesn't trust us, so why would we think any other way? Look, within humanity there's so many good things. I think what we've got to remember is that within our imperfection, that's where we find our true humanity. So we didn't come to the earth to be perfect. You know, we didn't come here to have all the answers. We came here to experience what it is to be human. We came here to learn, to grow, and to be nurtured in this physical realm. And I think a lot of people forget that. I think a lot of people forget that that's what it's really all about.
And there's often people are so fixated on the journey and to get to a point, but they don't think about the path that they take to get there. And it's like, oh, there's only one way to spirituality, but there are many. There's many things they can do.
Yeah, there's no one answer. Because, you know, like I say, there's 7.5 billion people on the earth, so therefore there's 7.5 billion ways to finding your truth.
And look, we, as children, we said before, you make agreements to believe all the things that we're told, and until we are aware enough of our own self, that's the time that we can experience those things. So do you think that there's an age group of people, so with children or adults, any particular time frame? It's just...
Well, for me, spiritual awakening happened. My earliest memories are of being spiritually aware. I think throughout my journey, people tried to beat that out of me and make me believe things the way they wanted me to believe, which took me down many paths. So I think, you know, we come to the earth with an awareness, but it's beaten out of us. You know, we're just not allowed to think for ourselves on this planet, in this world system that we live in.